Hey there, my name is Ranger Lane with Texas Parks and Wildlife, and today we're here at Ray Roberts Lake State Park, and I'll be teaching you about the most wiliest animal in Texas, the coyote. Coyote actually translates to trickster in the Mexican-Spanish Aztec root, and coyotes get a bad reputation. But here in Texas, we have the most coyotes out of any other state, and what that means, it's howling good news for these wild places. Coyotes are a keystone species, just like the North American beaver and the fox squirrel. These species keep these ecosystems functioning properly and without drastically changing. Coyotes, for example, keep small prey populations down, like rabbits and especially rodents. Also, like our turkey vulture and our black vulture, they'll eat carrion, which means they scavenge dead animals, and that reduces the risk for disease. Our furry friends are also opportunistic, omnivore feeders. Their teeth actually allow them to have this wide variety of diet. So they're even able to eat birds, insects, and even vegetation like juniper berries. Their arch nemesis, the greater roadrunner, stands no chance, with the coyote running up to 43 miles per hour and the greater roadrunner only having a speed of 26 miles per hour. There's no competition. Now, coyotes are also known for getting into trash, just like our furry bandits, the raccoon. The coyote's expansion has gone throughout Canada, Mexico, and all the United States besides Hawaii. Now, this is due to humans taking out populations of their past predators like wolves, cougars, and bears. Coyotes thrive in urban and suburban environments. They do this by using drainage ditches, alleyways, and even changing their behavior to nocturnal just to avoid humans. Now, you might say, "Hey, Ranger Lane, I swear I saw a wolf in my backyard last night." And I'll ask you, did you look for the telltale signs? Some of the telltale signs I'm talking about are their snout, their ears, their legs, and their tail. For their legs, they'll have long, lanky legs, really thin. For their snout, they have very narrow snout. For their ears, they're gonna have tall, pointy ears. And on their tail, which is a great identifier, is looking for that black tip. Coyotes are highly social animals. Their nickname is actually song dogs. So they have 11 different vocalizations that they can use, and most notably, their howl is a great call for territorial boundaries. There's a misconception about howling in the night and that's when they capture their prey. But actually, this might entice other hungry competitors. So would that be an evolutionary advantage or disadvantage? Coyotes will also communicate using scat. Now, this marks territorial boundaries between other coyotes, and this is why you'll see it right in the middle of a trail, because it makes it easy for other coyotes to notice. Inside these territorial boundaries are coyote packs. These consist of one alpha female and one alpha male. These are monogamous, which means they'll mate for life. Additionally, you can find 4 to 8 members depending on their food resource availability for that year. The family consists of either grown pups, and sometimes they'll even adopt solitary coyotes into the pack if they trust them. When on the trail, if you happen to see a coyote, what do you do? Well, first, if you have a pet, make sure it's always on a leash. Otherwise, you may have an unwanted experience. Now, coyotes don't see pets as food, but they'll see them as threats. We love our furry friends at home, but don't forget about the furry friends behind the scenes that take care of these natural places we use, the wily and crucial coyote.